I mean, for us playing Twitter since 2009, we know all the time until now there are spam bots, there are fake bots, there are scammers lurking around on Twitter. We already knew since 2009 until today. It's not like, hey, suddenly I discovered about it. Step number one, he needed a cover to sell his stocks to raise the cash. So he did that. He said, I want to buy Twitter. Then he found a reason. He told everybody, oh, I'm selling this amount of stocks, of Tesla stocks, to get the money in preparation to own Twitter. So he must make it believable. Right? So at first he was a passive investor. The board invited him to join the board of director, and then he turned it down and he changed his filing to become an activist investor. Then he upped his stakes of Twitter, right? Because back then he must have a reason to sell off Tesla stock, his own Tesla stocks, to go and buy Twitter, and he found the perfect reason. Okay, so of course, true enough, the stock price kind of spiked up because his price was $54.40, and you know, back then it was trading way below and the price of Twitter went up. So let's take a look at Twitter price, which is found right here, TWTR. So this was the moment in time, you know, the Twitter price spiked up. This box was because of Elon Musk's announcement. Okay, after that, you know, he start to kind of antagonize the company. Oh, there are spam bots. Oh, you know, the team probably, most of them will be retrenched. And he even held the town hall meetings. All these are things, it's also fake, all right? So finally, you know, he walked away. He wanted to walk away from this deal without even paying the $1 billion. So this is where, you know, they have forced the hands of Twitter. The board has to sue Elon Musk to compel him to buy the company.